So, assalamualaikum and hi. Today, kita masuk balik on the one yang we left last Tuesday, which is example 2. So, according to one of your friend, Adriana, dia suggest juga pakai 40-20. Betul, Adriana?
Betul, Miss.
Dia suggest pakai 40-20. So, this one, I proceed lagi, eh. Sebab kita dah done with the 60-20, 16, okay. From table, provide 40-20. Okay, you don't need to do both. Maksud saya tak perlulah you nak saja sampai two types of bar, two sizes, eh. Tak perlu. But you just ambil salah satu lah. Okay, according to your design. This one, I just bagi example saja. Eh. The check at S for 40-20, it is 1260, masih lagi besar daripada AS yang minimum yang you kira. Eh. We can check for the spacing. You know that? I dah tak nak lukis, eh? You dah faham kot? Mesti 275, which is B, kena minus dengan number of bar, which is 4 numbers of 20mm diameter, and then minus with link, which is kita assume 2 darab 10mm. Kita tolak lagi dengan concrete cover. Okay, kanan dan kiri, so 2 lah. 25mm. And then we divide it with, since kita punya bar is 4, so 4 minus 1 lah. Sebab spacing in between bars tu yang kita nak. So ada 3 spacing yang sama. Kita nak satu je, so kita bagi 3, eh. Cornelia?
Yes, Miss. Saya dapat 41.667.
7. Okay. 667. Yeah. Okay, thank you. So 41.667, which means this one is bigger than aggregate size plus 5mm. Okay, sebab aggregate size normally kita pakai 20mm, maximum aggregate size lah, plus 5mm, jadi 25. Therefore, okay lah. Then what we can do next is kita boleh design. Tapi kita nak design, we must get the value of H. Sebab kita nak buat dia punya detailing, eh. We need to write H is equal to, okay, this one, D plus half of the bar plus bar diameter prime, which is diameter of link, and plus C. This one kita bahagi dua, eh, diameter of main reinforcement. Because kita tak buat stacking. Tak ada stacking. Dia memang satu layer je. 4 biji. Deret. So our D is, tak payah cek jauh-jauh. You boleh tengok dekat atas tu je. Saya punya detailing yang lagi satu tu, kan. 450 tu memang dia punya D, eh. Plus, since kita pakai 20mm. So put 20mm. Jangan bantai letak 25, eh. You mesti tahu apa yang you tulis. You jangan tiru je saya punya example. Mesti ikut you punya soalan. 10mm. This one is assume. And plus 25mm the concrete cover. Errol Oswald, can you give me the value?
Hello? Hello?
Yeah?
495mm.
495mm. Ya, betul. 495mm ni betul. Tak ada masalah. Because dekat belakang tu 5mm. Kita tak payahlah nak round up lagi ke. Tapi you boleh round up kalau you rasa you don't like the number. Bukanlah maksud tak suka. You tak suka nombor 5 kat belakang tu, kan. Kita juga sebab designer dia boleh letak juga S500. Sebab dia lagi tepat, kan. 500. Right? Tak kisahlah sebab nanti concrete cover you akan tebal sikit lah. Concrete cover tu boleh cover lagi 5mm. 5mm tu tak besar mana, eh. Then kita boleh draw. Kalau I pakai je 495, eh, I tak ada masalah. Dia berpusing lah, ya. Beam ni punya link. And then we draw the main reinforcement. We have 4 numbers. Okay, jangan ikut saya punya lain-lain tu. Sebab ini ikut contoh ni lah. You dah letak 40-20, kan. Put 40-20. And you also have hanger bar on the top. Then we can label. This is a 40-20, the number of bars and the size. And you also have 2T12 as the hanger bar. And you also have R10 links 10 miles still. Sebab dia dah bagi ya, dekat dalam soalan dia kata FY V untuk links adalah 250. So you tahu dia pakai miles still eh. So miles still means R eh. So size yang kita assume adalah 10 mm. And we have B, which is 275. And then okay, ini mesti sampai centroid. Okay, balance dekat bawah ni. Ini 450, the D value. And balance dekat bawah tu, okay, you ambil je 495. Sebab 495 ni total height. So minus effective depth, you dapatlah balance yang dekat bawah tu berapa. So 495 yang you dah kira, ataupun 500 lah if you round it up little bit more. 495, I pakai 495 minus with the effective depth, which is 450. So kalau I pakai 495, then I get 45 as the balance. So ini 45 mm. Kalau you pakai 500, then kat sini akan jadi 50 mm. Jangan saling dua-dua, ikut you punya. Okay, kalau you pakai 495, I letak situ 45. Kalau you pakai 500, letak situ 50.
Miss.
Yo.
Untuk spacing tu kan yang divide by 3 tu, macam mana nak tahu dia divide by 3 ataupun divide by 5?
Number of bar minus 1. Okay, number of bar tu you ikut macam ni sebenarnya. Okay, kalau you nak lagi faham, you cuba draw. Okay, bila you draw, you akan nampak. Kalau satu atau satu dua, I abaikan link kan malah lukis. 4. So kalau 4, kan spacing dia ni ada 1, 2, 3. That's why I bagi 3. Kalau macam example kat atas ni, kita buat stacking. So number of bar tu dah tak applicable lah sebenarnya. Kalau you nak pakai, you pakai that formula kan. Sebab I ada bagi formula tu dekat dalam GC. Dalam notes eh. Tapi mungkin tak applicable. Sebab number of bar you 6. Tapi sebenarnya you tak ada stacking macam ni. So you sebenarnya nak kan ni. Berapa spacing yang dia ada tu. So kalau this one, you 6 tolak 1. Sebenarnya dia jadi 5. Betul, sebab 6 number of bar, you tolak 1 jadi 5. Tapi sebenarnya dia 2, dia punya spacing tu 2 je, you bagi 2 je. Sebab you letak dia stacking. So kalau you nak lagi senang faham, draw lah. Okay, cuba draw and then you will know how many, you nak divide dengan berapa eh.
Thank you, Miss.
Okay, kita proceed with, okay, ini dalam GC, I ada share with you. Exercise number 1. And I also have announcement. For this semester, dia dah tukar lagi the syllabus. For structure, tak ada final test. Ada presentation. I don't really know how actually it's going to be conducted because the resource person, the person yang dekat Perak lah yang responsible for this subject, haven't yet brief how actually it's going to be conducted. So I'm waiting for them untuk bagi tahu saya lah. Okay, macam mana cara dia conduct exercise one eh. A simply supported rectangular beam of 6 meters span carries characteristic that including self weight of beam. Okay, including. So GK dah termasuk dengan self weight which is 45 kilonewton per meter. And QK, impulse load is 10 kilonewton per meter. Respectively, dekat atas ni, sorry ya, ada typo. 45 ni adalah GK and QK adalah 10. Ikut soalan yang ditulis eh. The beam is composed of grade 30, which means that bila you nampak je grade 30, you tahu FCU will be 30 newton over mm square. Design the bending and shear reinforcements. I padam and shear ni lah sebab kita tak design shear eh. Bending reinforcement for beam showed in figure using high yield steel for main reinforcement. So you know that bila dia kata high yield steel must be untuk main steel eh. So mesti T lah. Okay, simbol T. Mesti you tahu so T20 ke T16 ke T32 ke. And FY dia, which is tensile strength for steel, bila high tensile, so 460. And mild steel for link, which simbol R lah. Tapi we don't really care about dia punya FY eh, sebab kita tak design. Kita just tahu dia pakai mild steel. Okay, so R. Nanti bila you nak sketch, you have to specify R berapa-berapa untuk link. Assume that the diameter, okay, equal to diameter of main reinforcement at 20 mm, and diameter for link adalah 10 mm. Okay, so kita tak payah assume the diameter size you punya main reinforcement dengan link lagi sebab dia dah bagi and you have to follow what's ever given here. Exactly exercise 1 ni sama macam example number 2. What do you need to do first? Christine, Abigail.
Loading ke mi?
Yes. So apa yang kita kena kira bawah loading?
Ultimate design.
Ultimate design apa?
Ultimate design load.
Alright, betul. Thank you. Okay, so we don't need to calculate the self-weight of the beam because in the question state, okay, dah ada self-weight of the beam included in GK punya value given. Okay, 45 kilonewton per meter tu dah termasuk dengan self-weight. Then we just use the formula of 1.4 GK plus 1.6 Q. Okay, Esther. Apa value dia?
79, miss.
Alright, betul. Thank you. Moving on to calculate the main steel. Hazik Mikdam. Apa kita kira bawah main steel?
Weight load square bagi 8. Saya bagi nombor boleh ke, miss? M equals to WL square bagi 8.
Okay, lepas tu macam mana kira?
79 darab 6 meter square bagi 8.
Okay, betul. Thank you. Iman. Isaac. Yusof.
Yes, miss. Yeah. 355.5, miss.
Okay, thank you. Betul. Berapa? Then what we need to do next, kita nak compare this ultimate design moment, okay, dengan ultimate moment resistance, which is MU. Okay, ultimate moment resistance. Dia ada nama-nama je lah. Kenapa nama dia resistance? Sebab dia yang resist the moment maximum value untuk dia jadi singly reinforced concrete beam. Kalau dia lebih besar, then dia double. Okay, FCU given in the question, dia dah bagi. I dah tulis kat atas ni. Sebab dia bagi grade 30. Jadi FCU dia adalah 30 Newton over mm square. And then value of B, 325 dan D, 547. Nur Shahira.
455-096-889.
Okay, thank you. Ini adalah unit dia Newton millimeter. But kita nak compare dengan M. M kita dalam kilo Newton meter. So kita convert. Millimeter tukar meter bagi 1000. Newton tukar kilo Newton bagi lagi 1000. Point, we going to get the value of 455.097 kilo Newton meter. We see that M is less than MU. Yeah. So kita nampak memang M ni less than 355.5 is less than 455.097, which means that okay lah, which means that no compression reinforcement is required. Okay, maksudnya tak perlulah nak ada compression reinforcement. Okay, kat atas ni dia akan jadi hanger bar. Kalau dia ada compression reinforcement, atas ni bukan hanger bar. Dia adalah compression reinforcement dekat atas ni. Tapi kita tak belajar until that. Kita belajar sampai hanger bar, which is singly lah. We can proceed with, okay. Nak tanya orang lagi. Nur Adiba.
Yes, miss.
Okay. What we do next?
Cari K.
Okay, cari K. Macam nak cari K?
M over FCU BD square.
Okay, thank you. Fine. The coefficient K ni kita boleh panggil juga coefficient tapi dia tak ada nama. Put the value of M which is 355.5. Okay, tapi ini adalah dalam kilo Newton meter. So kita convert dia kepada Newton millimeter, which means that you kena darab 1000, dia akan jadi Newton. Darab lagi 1000 millimeter. And the FCU is 30 Newton over mm square. Darab B B kita is 3, 2, 5. You tak payah tengok jauh-jauh eh. Kalau you dah biasa kira, you boleh nampak. You boleh pakai je balik value ni. 30 tu FCU. B ni 325. D 54. 7. Ambil je value tu. Nur Hafizah Bakri. Berapa?
0.122.
Okay. So, thank you. So, it is 0.12185965. So, kalau you round up, dia jadi 0.122. Value ni mesti akan less than that 0.156 sebab 0.156 ni adalah K prime. Okay. Kalau M out M yang you kira lebih besar daripada MU, K you akan dapat obviously akan besar daripada K prime. Kita calculate Z. Anis Natasha.
Yeah, miss.
Okay. Berapa value Z?
0.838.
Okay, betul. Thank you. Then kita check value dia less than 0.95 D. As what I have explained before, kalau dia less then kita akan pakai 0.838 D ni dalam calculation of AS. AS tu till area. Normally for beam, value Z ni takkan lebih daripada 0.95. Kalau you dapat lebih, there must be something wrong. Normally, kalau you kira untuk RC slab, RC footing, yes. Akan ada lebih besar daripada 0.95. Steel area, which is AS. M, 0.95, FYZ. Okay, so value of M, 355.5, yeah, kilo newton meter. Tukar kepada Newton millimeter. So kalau you darat 10 kos 3, darat 10 kos 3, darat 1000, darat 1000. So maksudnya darat 10 kos 6 kan? Divide 0.95. And 460 given dia dah bagi for main steel, it use high tensile steel. So high tensile FY dia 460. Newton over mm square. And Z just fill in 0.838. And D is according to the question, which is 547. Jawapan saya 1774.708. Okay. Next, Amy Nur Melissa. Boleh suggest dekat saya you nak pakai berapa? Yang mana?
4025, miss.
4025. Okay. 4025. Okay, tapi kita kena tengok eh. Dia dah bagi assume bar diameter 20mm. So dia dah bagi diameter of bar. Kita kena stick to whatever question bagi walaupun dia tulis assume je. Tapi dia suruh juga you ikut sebenarnya. So any other suggestion? Amy Nur Melissa.
60-20.
Okay, so it is 60-20. 1890. Provide 60-20 with AS 1890 mm square. So kalau you nampak number of bar sampai 6, okay ke nak buat dia single layer sahaja? Saya dah test dengan kelas C, boleh buat single layer saja. Spacing dia cukup. Okay. Tapi you boleh juga kalau nak buat dia stacking. Tak ada masalah. So spacing B dia 325. Okay. Kalau you tengok macam mana you agak-agak you rasa macam cukup ke tak cukup. 325mm tu besar. Lebar. Dia lebar. Beam you lebar. Kalau beam mungkin 200mm je width. Dia punya breadth. Okay. Probably tak boleh. Sebab sampai 6 numbers eh. Reinforcement bar. Minus 2 darab 10mm. Given eh, dia dah bagi 10mm. Link ni bukan I assume given. Minus 2 darab 25mm. And we just divide it with 5. So kalau kat sini you bolehlah terus pakai number of bar minus 1 sebab kita tak pakai staking. Tak payah nak draw pun. Tak payah nak agak-agak pun. Sebenarnya dia macam okay. Number of bar minus 1. Farah Lamya. Berapa?
27.
Okay, betul. Thank you. 27mm, which is bigger than aggregate size plus 5mm. Kita boleh draw. Marilah kita draw. Ada satu. Ui, besarnya. Dua. Tiga. Empat. Lima. Enam. Enam biji. And then we have a hanger bar, which is 2T12. So I have two label. So 60, 20. And above here is 2T12. Which is the hanger bar. This is assume only. Normally kita pakai macam ni lah untuk hang eh. And we have the R10 link. Okay. Okay, for link, I nak bagi tahu sikit lah. Kalau you belajar design eh untuk link, normally apa yang you akan kira, apa yang you cari adalah dia punya spacing sebenarnya. Okay, sebab link ni dia berpusing. Kan, lihat you ada bar macam ni. Okay, dia berpusing. So dia pusing lagi kat belakang. Dia pusing lagi. So distance between this yang you kena cari, spacing dia. Okay, normally kalau link, manalah tahu. Later masa you degree mungkin you belajar, mungkin akan belajar, kena belajar spacing ni lah. So kalau biasanya orang tulis R10, okay R10 tu size dia. And then dash, for example, I letak 200. 200 ni apa? Dia letak macam ni je. The one yang akan construct, which is the contractor ke, akan faham apa maksud 200 ni. 200 ni spacing. Okay, 200 ni lah jarak antara link from the one yang satu yang dekat depan, mungkin dekat belakang dia berapa jarak 200. And then jarak lagi 200. Jarak dia sama je 200. We have the value for D, which is 547. Okay, ini dia sampai centroid dia. Centroid of main reinforcement. So for H, kita kira H equal to D plus, okay ini dah jadi half bar. Kenapa kita perlu H? Sebab kita nak dapatkan berapa value kat sini. H half bar, dia bukan full bar lagi sebab tak ada stacking kat sini. Plus dengan diameter of link, and we going to plus the value of C. D is 547 plus with half of the bar, which is we use 20mm diameter of bar. Okay, berapa I dapat? Okay, I dapat 592. So 592, nombor ni tak cantik eh. 592. Okay, you boleh round up dia sebab I dah pernah bagi tahu. Mungkin kalau kat belakang tu mungkin you boleh leave it as 5 ataupun as 0 eh. You round up dia. Jangan round down, jangan letak 590. 590 tak cukup. Nanti concrete cover you hilang 2 mm. Mesti lebih. So 595 ataupun you boleh juga letak 600 pun boleh. Okay, tapi I suka, I biar je 595 eh. Asalkan dia lagi besar. So macam mana you dapat value yang dekat sini. So you ambil je 595 ataupun 600 minuskan dengan 547. Okay, dia punya effective depth. H minus effective depth, you dapat balance dekat situ 48. Okay, kalau you pakai 600, you akan dapat 53. Thank you so much. I end the class here. It's already 1-2 minutes. Goodbye. Assalamualaikum.
Thank you, Miss.
Thank you, Miss.